There are two interesting assumptions implicit in the search for charismatic leaders. The first is that leadership is a function of personality, which means that some people have more talent for leadership than others. And that assumption is well documented. The second assumption is that people with charisma have more talent for leadership than people without charisma. And this assumption is just false. Charisma degrades leadership for three reasons. First, narcissists and psychopaths specialize in seduction and manipulation, and they are really charming and fascinating. Narcissists and psychopaths are charismatic, they are attractive, and the data on the performance of narcissistic leaders is perfectly clear. They ruin organizations. They make commitments they can't keep, they overextend resources, and they underestimate how difficult it's going to be to implement their grandiose visions. And they just ignore any kind of negative feedback and objections. Second, a fellow named Jim Collins, he studied the Fortune 1000 companies, looking for companies that had performed significantly above the standard for the industry for a sustained period of time. He found 11 companies that fit that pattern, and he said, what was it that made them more effective than their competitors? To his enormous surprise, he thought the answer was the personalities of the CEOs. There were 11 of these guys, all 11 of them. When you walked in the room, you couldn't tell who the CEO was because they were self-effacing, they were quiet, they were reserved, they were even shy. But beneath the surface, they were fiercely ambitious, tremendously competitive, utterly tenacious, but modest and humble. Third, in contrast with charismatic leaders, humble leaders admit their mistakes, they're willing to listen to feedback, they're willing to solicit input from knowledgeable subordinates, and this creates an environment of continuous improvement. Humility can be defined in terms of three behavioral tendencies. First, trying to see oneself accurately and listening to feedback from others in order to see oneself accurately. Second, appreciating the strengths and contributions of other people, understanding if they have something to contribute. And then finally, being open to new ideas from other people, not just understanding that they're good, but being open to their ideas. It's important to remember that humility is only important when it's combined with real confidence. If you're humble and incompetent, people will see that in a hurry and think you're just weak.